Analysis of the short story Uncle Ernest by Alan Sillitoe. As usual, I'm Manusha Thennakon. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe it for more videos. Content of today's presentation. I'm going to give you a thorough understanding about the short story, paying attention to the following areas. Number one, the writer. Number two, the plot. Number three, setting. Number four, characters. Number five, themes. The writer. The writer of the short story Uncle Ernest is Alan Sillitoe. Alan Sillitoe was an English writer. He was born in 1928 and he died in 2010. He is called one of the so-called angry young men of the 1950s. Alan Sillitoe was a part of a generation of working class writers who shifted the boundaries of taste. Sillitoe's heroes in short stories are definitely from working class, and also they were untrammeled egoists who reject old authority. The short story Uncle Ernest is one of the short stories in the collection of short stories titled The Loneliness of the Long Distance Runner. The plot. Now let's pay our attention to the plot of the story. Ernest, who was once a soldier during First World War, spends a lonely life without any positive anticipation about the future. He eats alone and sleeps alone. He has no family to comfort him. When others see him, they view him as a ghost. Ernest always wishes that he should have died along with his comrades in the battlefield. As he did not die so, he lives with a feeling of guilt about himself. His solution to this guilty feeling is to crawl in a bottle. As he spends all of his money, which he earns working as an upholsterer on booze. However, Ernest's life changes for the better when a pair of young sisters, Alma and John, begin to keep him company. The girls befriend him, and eventually he begins to buy them food and talk to them on a regular basis. He views them as his own daughters and the only people he has to love. Ernest is accused of leading the girls in the wrong direction. Ernest was misunderstood as a pedophile. This accusation splits Ernest from both girls, and they all depart in their own ways. Ernest back to the bar, and the girls back to where they came from. Ernest doesn't care about anything after that. Setting. The story Uncle Ernest is set in the post-war slums of England. Characters. There are altogether five characters in this short story, Uncle Ernest. Ernest Brown is the title character, protagonist. Alma and John, they are the secondary characters. Brunette and two policemen can be considered as minor characters. Now, let's pay our attention to the themes of the short story. Theme number one, criticism on legal system. Ernest Brown, who was a drunkard, stopped drinking and started living with an aim of life after he met two girls, Alma and John. He came to the correct track of life out of his own choice. The purpose of the legal system of a country is to put people onto the correct path when they go on wrong path. But here, what happens at the end of the short story indicates something opposite to that. The legal system of England, according to this story, was blind. It could not recognize the correct person. Instead, it misunderstood correct person as the wrong person. Two police officers in the story who represent the legal system accuse Ernest as a pedophile. But he is not a pedophile. He treated two girls as his own daughters. As a result of this baseless accusation made by the society and the police officers, Ernest, who stepped onto the correct path of life because of the two girls, stepped back to the wrong path once again. When the story ends, it indicates that Ernest is once again going to the saloon bar. Theme number 2. Post-war slums in England and the sufferings of the poor. The story gives a vivid description of the post-war slums in England and how poor people are suffering. People in these slums live in a dirty environment. It is visible in the following description. And a treacherous wind lashed out its gust, sending paper and cigarette packets cartwheeling along unswept gutters. People lived in post-war slums in England lived with the feelings of insecurity. According to this story, people do not have a secured feeling even at their own place. Every night before returning to his lodging, Ernest used to leave his toolkit for safety at the public lavatory. Every night before returning to his lodgings, he left the bag of tools for safety with a man who looked after the public lavatory near the town center, for he felt there was a risk of them being lost or stolen should he take them back to his room. Two girls, Alma and John, represent poor people and their sufferings. They can't buy a piece of cake because if they do so, they lose money for their bus fare. They are in hunger for most of the time. Alma answers Ernest's question, telling her mother works all the day. Theme number 3, how badly past influence on present. Don't cry over the past, it's gone. Don't stress about the future, it hasn't arrived. Live in the present and make it beautiful. Even though people simply say, let bygones be bygones, sometimes it is not easy for some people to forget the past. But whatever it is, if a person sticks into his past limitlessly, it affects negatively on him. That is what happened to Ernest in the story, Uncle Ernest. As he is worrying about 30 years of vacuum in his life, he doesn't feel thinking positively about his future. He tried to remember things that had happened and felt panic when he discovered a 30-year vacuum. All he could see behind was a gray mist, and all he could see before him was the same unpredictable fog that would hide nothing. Theme number 4, how loneliness can be cracked. Loneliness is a state of mind linked to wanting human contact but feeling alone. No human beings love to be alone. But still, some people like Ernest Brown experience bitter taste of loneliness. Those who experience loneliness consider it as a curse, but do not take remedies to chase it away. The person who suffers from loneliness only should take initiative to chase it away. Without taking initiatives, there's no point of blaming others for your own loneliness. Ernest Brown could get rid of his loneliness as he broke the spell, asking what's the matter from the girls when the younger one was crying. That was the turning point where his loneliness started split into parts. Theme number 5, class-oriented code of values which pits the disadvantaged working class against the rest of society. Society has established class-oriented values, and they stand against working class. Ernest Brown belongs to the working class. His appearance is not a decent appearance. When a complaint was made against Ernest at the police station, even the police officers thought that the complaint against him was correct, because the common assumption in society is that people from Ernest's social class do such things. Theme number 6. Happiness is around you. You have to identify it. It does not count much. People search for happiness everywhere, but happiness is always close to you. Your problem is with your inability to find it. Ernest had an immense happiness after he befriended with the two girls, Alma and John. We have come to the end of today's presentation. Hope to meet you once again with an educational video like this. Thank you very much.